Today we're going to talk about the resting membrane potential, and all that is by definition is the fact that the inside of cell membranes is negatively charged compared to the outside of cell membranes. Here's our little cartoon voltmeter showing a charge of negative 70. Again, that's the inside relative to the outside. If our voltmeter had its reference and recording electrode switched, it would read positive 70. So it's a bit arbitrary to say it's the inside of the cell membrane relative to the out. Okay, so this resting membrane potential actually exists only along the cell membrane. It is a property of the cell membrane and only affects things at the cell membrane. You might think that if the inside of the cell is negatively charged, that negative charge would spread throughout the inside of the cell, and the whole inside of the cell would be negatively charged, or in any case, the charges would mix in that area. The reason that doesn't happen is only because this negative charge, this negatively charged state along the inside of the cell membrane, is being continuously created, as we'll see. Okay, so we have here a difference in charge, which is maintained across the cell membrane, so we're not at equilibrium. The charges are not at equilibrium. And whenever you see a state away from equilibrium, a situation where we're not at equilibrium, there must be some source of energy that's creating that. And the source of energy for the resting membrane potential is the sodium-potassium pump. So the sodium-potassium pump is continuously pumping sodium outside the cell membrane and potassium inside the cell membrane by using ATP, right? By hydrolyzing ATP, burning ATP to do this. So there's a continuous input of energy to create these concentration gradients. Now you might look at this and say, well, this is the thing that's creating the resting membrane potential, especially if you know that there are actually three sodium ions pumped out for every two potassium ions pumped in. It seems like that ratio could make the inside of the cell more negative. However, this is actually not the source of the resting membrane potential, or only for a tiny bit of it, as we'll see later. Instead, the function of the sodium-potassium pump is to create huge concentration gradients of sodium and potassium, indicated here by the larger font of sodium outside the cell membrane and potassium inside. These differences are tenfold or more, that is, there's 10 times as much sodium outside cell membranes than in, and the same for potassium in the other direction. We can see this maybe a little more visually in this slide, where the potassium are indicated by purple diamonds and the sodium by yellow circles. The problem with this slide is that it implies that the entire inside of the cell has an accumulation of potassium, and that's not the case. It's right along the cell membrane. But still, you can see here the pump, pumping potassium in and sodium out, and the resulting concentration gradients. Okay, so what are these concentration gradients for? Well, sodium's concentration gradient doesn't really concern us today. It has many functions, and a big one is to create the action potential. But at rest, sodium can't really influence anything because it doesn't have any permeability in the membrane. It can't cross the cell membrane and create any changes. So at rest, sodium sort of isn't important. What is important, though, is potassium. Again, you have a high concentration of potassium inside the cell membrane relative to the outside of the cell membrane, and there is, in fact, permeability in the membrane at rest to potassium. That is, there are channels that are open at rest that are selective for potassium. Now, a channel allows diffusion, and diffusion is always toward equilibrium, so it could be in either direction. Of course, you're going to get movement of potassium in both directions through this channel. However, the net movement of potassium is going to be out because of that huge concentration gradient, right? Here's the pump bringing potassium into the inside of the cell membrane. And so there's simply going to be more potassium there to leave than there is on the other side available to enter. So it's just a probabilistically, you're more likely to have potassium ions leaving. So net, you have potassium ions leaving. As they do so, by definition, right, if a positive charge is leaving, it's making the inside of the cell membrane more negative. And that indeed is the cause of the resting membrane potential. So if we look at this difference in charge across the membrane, it is directly created continuously in every moment of your entire life by the leaking, as it's often called, of potassium out of the cell membrane. This leaking does not cancel the concentration gradient of potassium. It's a very small magnitude movement relative to the pumping of potassium inside the cell. So the concentration gradient isn't changed by this movement, but the charge is changed. As that potassium moves out of the cell, again, it's just reasonable, right, that as you take positive charge out of the cell, you're going to make the inside of the cell more negative. Now, to be precise, we should be clear that actually about 67 millivolts of the 70 are created by this potassium movement, and the other three are created by the sodium-potassium pump. As noted earlier, it pumps out three sodiums for every two potassiums it brings in, and that is an electrogenic movement, that is a movement that creates a charge difference, but that charge difference is very small as compared to that created by the movement of potassium. Okay, so we have this resting membrane potential. Who cares? What is it for? Well, it has many functions, and it certainly depends on the cell type. But as you move forward in your study of the nervous system, the function that you want to focus on for this resting membrane potential is allowing the action potential to occur. In other words, what have we done here? We've created a situation where the inside of the cell is negatively charged, right? And you have all these positively charged ions, sodium ions, lined up along the outside of the cell membrane, 10 times as much sodium outside the cell membrane as inside the cell membrane. So imagine what happens when you open sodium channels. It has a tremendous driving force. It's going to diffuse at a tremendously fast rate through its channels into the cell because it has a huge concentration gradient and a huge charge attraction, right? The inside of the cell is so negative, sodium positively charged ion, it's going to move in really fast, and the speed is important. Because when you move and you think and you sense things, you want that to be fast. The reason you can move and sense and think so quickly is because all of that is underlain by a fast movement of potassium, which can spread throughout your entire nervous system in a few milliseconds or in several milliseconds. All of that is only possible because of our resting membrane potential. It's pretty awesome. All right, if you have any questions, let me know.